Why is it that Muslims only eat halal meat? Well, the Quran tells us, وَلَا تَعْكُلُ مِمَّا عَلَمْ يُزْكَرِ اسْمُ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَإِنَّهُ لَفِسْقُ. That is in Surah Al-An'am, chapter 6, verse 121. Eat not of meats on which Allah's name has not been pronounced. That would be great disobedience. And of course we read in the Bible in Act 15:29, and ye abstain from meats offered to idols, and from blood, and from things strangled, and from fornication. In fact, on a radio program, they were in the studio sitting a rabbi and a priest, and then the moderator phoned me. And he said, well, I have here with me sitting a rabbi and a priest. The rabbi, of course, he says that, look, we are only allowed to eat kosher meat. But the priest says that this injunction is not applicable to the Christians. Well, I said it is, because in Acts 15:29 we read, and ye abstain from meats offered to idols, and from blood, and from things strangled, and from fornication. And fornication here in this context means any unlawful meat. So the priest, on the other hand, he said, ah, but you see, this verse is only applicable to the Jews, not to the Gentiles. I said, okay, then how about Act 21:25, where it says, Gentiles, and goes on, keep themselves away from things offered to idols, and from blood, and from things strangled, and from fornication. Again, it's repeated for the Gentiles also. So this he had no answer. Now the point is, all godly faiths forbid the consumption of blood, and certain conditions have to be satisfied when slaughtering an animal. For instance, you see, a Muslim is not allowed to take any life, even animal's life, unless it is with the categorical permission of the Creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is why when Muslims slaughter an animal, they pronounce Bismillahi Allahu Akbar. That is to confess the fact that we are slaughtering this animal because God Almighty has given us permission to do so, to slaughter this animal for food, not for joy, not for fun, not for play. And also, according to Ahadith, there are strict conditions that have to be satisfied, so that the knife must be sharp and so on, so that the least possible pain is caused to the animal. So now, just to wind up this session, you see, we find that Jews only eat kosher meat, and Muslims only eat halal meat. And there is no difference really between kosher and halal. Because halal, a person who is slaughtering must be a person who believes in a monotheistic faith in God Almighty, in the oneness of Allah. He must pronounce the kalimas, Bismillahi Allahu Akbar, beginning in the name of Allah, Allah the Most Great, and slaughter in a manner that the blood comes out of the body of the animal, because the consumption of blood is forbidden by all godly faiths. And point to remember is that Jews only eat kosher meat, Muslims only eat halal meat, and there is no difference between the two, actually, apart from the fact that it is called kosher in Hebrew and it is called halal in Arabic. So Muslims only eat halal meat, Jews only eat kosher meat, and Jesus, peace be upon him, only ate kosher meat. Jazakallah shukran. We shall now rise for sunnah, inshallah. Akhiru da'wan, alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.